So you probably already know that if you open an image in the Preview app or even a PDF, you can draw on it. You can click on the markup tools here, get all these extra tools and do various things. The pen tool is particularly interesting because you can draw freehand on the image. So let's select that. I've also selected the color red here. So we can draw something. Let's try to draw a circle. And you can see I'm drawing a rough circle, not perfect. But when I release, you can see I get a perfect circle. Now you have a choice here. At this point, you can use this perfect circle that has been substituted for your rough one, or you can go over here to this little drop down menu that has appeared and select between your original rough circle or the perfect one. Go to either one, select it, and now that's there. So you have the option of drawing a perfect shape or the rough shape. And you can do this for a variety of shapes. So for instance, I could do a square. And you can see it makes it perfect, but I could select the rough one. Let's select the rough one there. You could do line. And actually that did it as a curve because my line was so bad. But here's a line. And you can see there. You could do triangles. You could do even arrows. Put an arrowhead on the end here. And you can see it actually converts that to an arrow. I have the option here under the line properties to actually remove the arrowhead or change its direction, all sorts of things. And of course I can also change the thickness of the line, everything afterwards. So let's look at more shapes. You can do a pentagon. And it corrects it. And again, I have the option here of what I want to do. You can do an oval. And you can even do an oval at an angle. And we'll get that. So you have lots of different things. Even a star works. You can see it recognizes that shape. And that's pretty much it. There probably are a few others, but the ones I played around with, these are the ones that it recognizes and then gives you the option of which one to choose. Sometimes you even get more than two options. Like if you try to confuse it and draw a shape like this, you notice here I get three options. The original, it interprets it as maybe a curve and maybe also interprets it as kind of a talk bubble here. It's trying to figure out what it is that you want. You can get some clues as to other things that you can do. So for instance, let's see if it thinks that a talk bubble is right. Oh, there you can see you could do this little simple talk bubble here or just a oval with a line. There's even like little curves like that. So I get these options here. I can try to draw a more perfect semicircle. And then you can always adjust it afterwards by grabbing different points in the curve. Now what you can do that's really cool at this point, once you have all these shapes here, is of course you can select them and do different things with them. So you kind of have to put your go over them until you get the hand cursor, which works better on some shapes than others. You can also go to Tools and Show Inspector. And here, if you click on the pencil tool here, you get a list of all the different shapes. And as you select them, it selects them on the screen there. After they're all drawn, there's nothing you can do to change them back to the original drawings or force it to smooth them or anything like that. But you can change the color. You can change the fill. You can change the line thickness. Things like that. For some shapes, you can change other things like the type of line. For the arrow here, of course, you can change arrow properties. And in most, you can also add or remove a shadow there as well. So you have some things that you can do with them after you're done drawing them. And of course, you can also select, drag them around. You can grab a corner and resize. So once you're done, if you save there and you close it, you reopen, you end up with the shapes there that are now permanent. They're no longer there as something that can be edited. So if you go, for instance, to Tools Inspector and look now there, you see that there are no shapes because these are permanently applied. The reason for this is because this is a JPEG image, and JPEG images are bitmap images. They don't have the ability to remember things like different shapes and all. So as long as you're still editing the original document, then you have this extra layer that's there in preview. But as soon as you save the JPEG, then you simply get a JPEG, which means you can't edit it any longer. However, of course, since you're using Preview, which is a modern Mac app, you can do a file, revert to, browse all versions, and go back to a previous version of this image here. So you can get rid of all of that, go back to the JPEG image as it was, and start over.